some excerpts from your book. I'm going to start the reading by reading the summary so you know what the book's about, and then we go into a little excerpt from the chapter. The 16-year-old Aurora Darlington is an orphan. Mistreated by her adopted family and bullied at school, she dreams of running away and being free. But when she is kidnapped and dragged through a portal into a magical world, suddenly her own life doesn't seem so bad. Avalonia is a dangerous land ruled by powerful mages and a cruel, selfish queen who will do anything to control all seven kingdoms, including killing anyone who stands in her way. Thrust headlong into this new magical world, Aurora's arrival sets plans in motion that threaten to destroy all she holds dear. With the help of a young fae, a magical pegasus, and a handsome mage, Aurora journeys across Avalonia to learn the truth about her past and unleash the power within herself. Kingdoms collide as a complicated web of political intrigue and ancient magic lead Aurora to unravel a shocking secret that will change her life forever. I'm now going to read an excerpt from the book. As I walked further into the gigantic library, I looked over to the wall at the very end of the room and was immediately mesmerized. The entire wall at the far end was covered with a huge tapestry that dominated the whole space. It was a delicate and elaborate one, depicting a dark forest surrounding a crystal clear lake with a magical castle glistening in the distance. Now I was positive that this was my favorite room in the house. I turned back to the bookshelves. Redstone Manor had an excellent connection. Where to start? The walls of the enormous room were packed from top to bottom with shelves, filled with seemingly countless array of books. Some were newly bought, and some looked as though they must have come from the house many centuries ago. This was like a dream come true. Just as I found the complete Chronicles of Narnia, I heard someone at the door. I don't know what came over me, but I panicked and dove behind one of the large leather armchairs. I knew I was not doing anything wrong, just borrowing a book, but I still felt spooked. I peered out from behind my hiding place, feeling immensely stupid. It was my Uncle Christopher. I tensed. Maybe he had come down to choose a book himself. That seemed like a reasonable explanation. I was about to come out from behind the chair and announce myself when I realized that he wasn't going towards the books, but towards the tapestry. What was he up to? My uncle stood unmoving in front of the tapestry and stared at it. I stayed where I was because I had no idea what he was doing, and I didn't want to startle him. He might get angry. I looked over towards the double doors of the library. They were shut, and there was no way I could leave the room without Uncle Christopher noticing. So I crouched and waited. My uncle was definitely acting very oddly. That was clear when he held out his arms, palms facing outward and touching the tapestry. As he did that, I felt a breeze enter the room. I turned to the windows, but they were shut. A rustling noise startled me. Noise and the breeze were coming from inside it. I spotted the bushes in the tapestry moving slightly, and sudden strange ripples started forming. Unexpectedly, a big booted leg and an arm came through the tapestry. Slowly, finally, a whole body emerged. I had to clap my hand over my mouth to prevent myself from gasping aloud. I couldn't believe, with a patch over one eye and a massive sword that swung at his rather large waist, had just stepped out of the tapestry and into the library of Redstone Manor.
Wonderful.
Right, we're going to have a few questions to ask you. So we're going to start with, what was your inspiration behind Last of the Fire Drakes, and what inspired you to write this book?